Well, of course, we have the trillion-dollar question that we've been focusing on in recent months especially, and frankly, ever since Trump got elected and we turned bullish, because you cannot argue with tax cuts and $2 trillion of repatriation, and that all goes into stock buybacks and stuff. So, you know, this bubble has now surpassed all bubbles in magnitude and length, all bull markets, you know, without a 20% correction. And again, the question is, when is this thing going to peak? Because bubbles always defy gravity, always keep going higher than anybody expects them to. And each bubble tends to be stronger than the last one. So that's what we're looking at. And I think that the good news, in a sense, is that this recent correction does appear to be just that. One of the things I look for, history will tell you the only way to know a bubble's actually over is when you get that first sharp crash. And it tends to be 42% in the first 2.6 months. And it can be anywhere from between 30% and 50% in 2 to 4 months. But what I do is I look at past bubble crashes, like the 29 top and the first crash and the NASDAQ, the first crash. And I say, okay, is this looking like that? Because I don't want it to be down 40% and then say, okay, it's over. We want to be able to tell early on. And basically, by comparing to those past drops, we can see that this is looking like a correction. The market should have been down 25, 30% now over 2 months into it, and 30 to 40% by the end of December. And that does not look like it's happening. Now, this market may have a little more to go. But it's best to see the markets outside of the NASDAQ, which did make substantial new highs in August, September. This market for most, you know, the Dow and the S&P and most markets has been basically sideways since the January top. And, you know, that January top and that move into January of 2018, that looked like a blow off top. That looked like, oh, this could be peaking. And we were looking at that. But of course, I applied the same discipline. Okay, are we looking like a 40% crash in the first 2 to 3 months? And of course, by April, it was obvious. No, this was a 10, 12% correction. As sharp as it was, it's a correction, not the beginning of a crash, because it was not following that crash pattern. This one, again, is not either. So what I think we're doing is we're basically building a one-year base, a sideways movement. That's bullish. Now, the other thing about bubbles is that, hey, this could have been a top two in late September, early October, but it didn't look like a top like the January top did. Bubbles tend to go out not with a whimper, but with a bang, with an orgasm. And so the odds are, if this is the correction it appears to be, that we may have a very strong final year. Now, remember, on our most important cycle now, the 45-year innovation cycle, doubled every 90 years, is where we see the biggest bubbles and the biggest resets, like 1837 to 1842 and 1929 to 32. Major depressions, major resets in real estate, stocks, and financial assets. And again, it comes once in a lifetime, even more than a lifetime for most people. So nobody's going to see this coming. This cycle hits around late 2019. That would be the ideal time for this bubble of all bubbles to top. So what happens between now and then? If this correction can continue to remain contained, and I'd say 23,000 to 24,000 is kind of where it should kind of bottom out, and we're near that, and this could happen any day now. And then we could start to launch into something that could last most of next year. And again, every rally in a bubble tends to get more exponential, more progressive. So we could literally see the markets go up as much next year as it did in the last few years, in the last peak into January, that sort of thing. And we could see the Dow go to 30,000, even as high as 35,000. The NASDAQ could go as high as 9 to 11,000. So we could get a really strong rally. We call that in our most recent promotion out there into the world, the dark window, how the last year and a half of a major bubble can be dramatic. And of course, the leading stocks can be even more so. So that's not something most people are projecting. You hear most Wall Street analysts, oh yeah, they think 2019 is going to be good, but not great. And the forecasts are modest. So two things are likely to happen. We have a much stronger year. And that's what we're positioning people for here, unless we start to show signs of a more dramatic breakdown. And that is not happening. Now, the wild card, the second scenario, is Donald Trump. I mean, this guy's getting boxed in every day, lies on lies. And you know, we don't know what's going to happen here. I can tell you it is tracking on a 45-year cycle with Watergate. And the thing that I noticed when we look back, that was happening during the 73 to 74 correction. Now, that was a time of steepening inflation, dramatic inflation, and recession. So the markets were going down for fundamental reasons. But there was Watergate unfolding. And what I noticed, the markets did not react when Haldeman and Ehrlichman, I call them the Nixon Nazis, his top aides, left. That was a sign something's wrong here. And then John Mitchell, another prominent person, left. And then John Dean ratted on Nixon. John Dean came out and said, not only did Nixon know about the cover-up, he planned every bit of it. Well, that was like Michael Cohen coming out with Trump. And how many of Trump's top aides and people have left? Almost everybody. So the markets didn't react to any of that. The markets reacted when Nixon panicked and had to fire the special prosecutor. So will Trump do that? The markets have not reacted to all of Trump's problems, but something like that, that desperate, could do it. So that's kind of the wild card. And there is another scenario where we just go up and maybe make slight new highs early next year, and then we top. But I'm telling you, that's not going to look like a bubble top. That's not the ideal scenario. The ideal scenario would be we get one more really strong fifth waves up. A blow-off rally into September or later in 2019, and then we have a 29 to 32-like crash right on that 90-year cycle. And again, bubbles like to go out on a bang, on an orgasm. And again, January 2018 top looked like that, but wasn't, because we didn't get the follow-through. We didn't get that 40% crash in the first couple of months, and it wasn't playing like that. So again, that's the trillion-dollar question. It does look like we're probably going to hold here. I'd say 2,500 on the S&P is critical. 23,000, 23,500 on the Dow is critical. If we can hold anywhere near there in the next couple of weeks, you know, through Christmas, whatever, then the odds are the markets are going to go up and probably starting early next year or maybe even in December. So that's the most likely scenario at this point. We will let you know, obviously, if it's starting to turn the other way. If this market's going to start to collapse and have a sharp crash, and I mean like down 20% in a couple of weeks. That's what the next wave down should be if we're in a crash. That should start soon, and it should be very hard, and it should be very obvious. So we will let you know. But for now, expect that 2019 could be a lot better than most people think. And we could make very, very strong profits in all our trading systems at Dent Research before we position you for the greatest bust of your lifetime. So stay tuned and we'll keep you updated.